So for the Earth and Sun and Moon album, we ended up in St. Peter's at Megaphone Studios, once again with Nick Launay. And we spent, once again, a lot longer in there than we expected. Once again, we thought maybe we could record an album in about 10 weeks. But seasons changed, you know. Suddenly we went from winter through to summer and then autumn, and we were still in St. Peter's. But anyway, one of the songs that came out of those sessions was My Country. And it was a bit of a different track in as much as the lead line, rather than Jim or Martin playing it on guitar, it's actually played by Jim on piano, and gives a sort of a lighter touch to the backing of the song. And it was a song originally I wrote about the kind of situation that a lot of young men find, I think, if they are sent overseas way too young to understand the real politic of what they're involved with. If they're sent overseas to fight for their country and they find themselves in a situation whereby they've got a moral choice to make, and which might be repugnant, but they're told that they have to follow orders. And so that's kind of what the song's about. It's about this terrible moral dilemma that often young men and women have to make in defense of their country. And it was, of course, that phrase, "My Country, Right or Wrong," was used by so many armies to justify so many atrocities. And it's always fascinated me, this clash of people's true nature and what they're forced to do, particularly young people. And so that's what the song's about. We ended up once again with Claudia Castle producing a film clip, this time in the Mojave Desert in California. It was about 40 degrees that day in our temperature. And I remember we were just sort of sitting in the shade waiting to do take after take. And the camera was built on the cameras were built on a revolving track around the band. So it's one of the most vertiginous film clips we ever made. You get quite giddy just watching it, which I thought was actually quite good, because thematically it kind of puts you in the situation of someone perhaps in the jungle or whatever, under heavy fire, and you know, you're completely disoriented and you're upside down and you make mistakes. And so I thought what she was getting at was pretty good for that song. And once again, a song that stayed with the band, and we played time again. When we had Chris Abrams with us playing piano, it enabled Chris to play that melodic line, and Jim would end up playing guitar again. But a song that was one which fitted nicely in to the other songs from that period that we played live, including the title track, Earth and Sun and Moon, and of course, Truganini, which was the first single.